You're listening to the audio production of The Sunshine Mind, 100 Days to Finding the Hope and Joy You Want, by Tanya Rad and Raquelle Stevens, published by Zondervan and read by the authors. Selena Gomez's foreword read by Raquelle Stevens. Foreword by Selena Gomez. I am so proud of Raquelle and Tanya for writing this book. Raquelle is like my sister and has been one of my closest friends for over a decade now. I can't think of a single word that would describe her better than bright. When it comes to light, optimism, and appreciating all that is good in our lives, there is no one better to have by your side than Raquelle. She is the person you call when you are worried, hurt, or scared. She is the one you call when something has fallen apart entirely and you can't seem to pick yourself back up. She is always right there to offer hope and perspective. She will hand you a little joy, happily. This joy is not flimsy. It is not an empty optimism that promises everything will become better right away, but an optimism which is grounded in truth. Raquelle has personally helped me through some of my own hardest times. When it comes to a partner for this book, I cannot think of a better person than Tanya. She is another friend who continues to fight for the good and believe for better times ahead. Both Raquelle and Tanya are a gift to those that know them. They are a gift to this city that we call home, and I think these words they have chosen to share will be a gift to you.
It is so easy to look out at the world around us and get discouraged. So many things feel broken. So many things feel beyond repair. And yet, there is still the choice to show up and believe that things could be a little bit better tomorrow. Raquelle and Tanya are people who are committed to this. While life is both good and hard, they choose hope. They choose trust. They choose grace and forgiveness and showing up for people in a way that makes a difference. This is so much of what it looks like to live a life that is bright. We can walk through these days choosing to give more than we take. We can look for ways to listen and love and care. We can choose to show up and serve long after it feels easy. We can choose to let the challenging things stretch us into who we want to become, and we can choose gratitude for every single good thing that we are given. I have watched Raquelle and Tanya live every bit of this out. They are strong and resilient and lighthearted through every season. I hope that the words of this book bring you comfort and perspective. I hope they leave you encouraged, and I hope they leave you feeling a little less alone. Because the truth is that every last one of us needs to be picked back up along the way. We all have moments of feeling tired or worn down or overwhelmed. May these words be like the many conversations I have had with these two friends. May they remind you that you carry everything you need to walk through the very season that you are in. May they remind you that joy is one of the greatest gifts we can carry with us. It's a strength that lifts and lightens us in the middle of days that are almost always both good and challenging. I think we all hope to live a generous life that matters to those around us. And while there are plenty of ways to do that, I can't think of anything better to bring than joy. I can't think of anything more necessary or needed in these very days than hope. So I hope that the unshaken hope, the courage, the sunshiny joy of these two friends of mine rub off on you as you read these words that they have shared. May this book meet you right where you are and lift you back up a little. This is what they have both done for me in so many moments, and I know their words can do the very same for you.
Introducing Tanya. My name is Tanya, and I am a modern woman. I march to the beat of my own drum. I am annoyingly optimistic. I give people the benefit of the doubt. I sing out loud when I go on my runs. Yes, I'm that person. I watch rom-coms on the daily. I'm a hopeful romantic. And my relationships are everything to me. The top questions I am always asked are, how are you always so happy? And how do you stay so positive? Well, the truth is, I'm not always, but that can be our little secret. I try to keep it real, and I exude happiness and positivity by choice, and I am able to maintain both because I am deeply rooted in my faith. In my 20s, I experienced a major heartbreak and felt enormous rejection. Little did I know I was being redirected to an even greater calling and destiny than the one I had imagined for myself. When I was laid off from my first job in radio, I doubted my abilities and felt terribly lost and hopeless. But a force much bigger than my own was pushing me out of a situation I now realize I would have never left on my own. I didn't know then that I was meant to be in a bigger city with a bigger platform. It's experiences like these that remind me there's always a plan, even when you can't see it. I've seen God work in beautiful ways in my life, and it's always changed me for the better from the inside out. My faith wasn't always this way. I was raised in the Serbian Orthodox Church. Being part of that church was more of a Sunday formality than an internal experience or connection. I didn't truly find my faith until I was in my early 20s. I hate to admit this, but that major heartbreak is what brought me to my knees and ultimately landed me in a Bible study. I'm a bleeding heart. I wear my soul on my sleeve. All I ever wanted in life was to get married and have babies. So when the one relationship I'd put all those expectations on came crashing down, I was left sleepless, hopeless, confused, weak, and majorly codependent on others. I didn't know who Tanya was, what she wanted in life, or even what she did for fun. I was a shell of a woman, and as hard as it is to admit, it took me feeling this low to become the strong, independent, self-sufficient, modern woman I am today. As I mentioned, this breakup left me on the floor. I was a cliche of a woman scorned. I went to too many parties. I was intimate with too many guys. I watched all the sad movies and ate way too much ice cream. Spoiler alert, none of it helped, not even a little. One day at work, I was crying in the hallway, which was a daily ritual for me at that point, when a friend of mine, Jason Kennedy, who was hosting for E! News at the time, saw me. He didn't know what was going on or why I was crying, but he came over to say that he was sorry for whatever I was going through and asked if I'd like to come to his Bible study that night. My mind raced. Bible study? He offered me Bible study? Not a good-looking single friend to set me up with, but Bible study? At that point, I had tried everything else, so I figured, why not give this a try? Plus, I was out of ice cream. So that night, I went to Bible study. I sat in the middle row, far to the left, and was moved to tears. It was as if the pastor knew exactly what to say to make me feel less alone. For the first time in months, I finally felt like myself again. One of the friends I met that night, Raquelle Stevens, the co-author of this book, is like my sister now. She was happy, self-assured, secure, and deeply rooted, which I so desperately wanted to be. She was and is sunshine in human form. Little did I know that night she would be a rock in my life, helping me navigate personalities, egos, contracts, you name it. The entertainment industry is not for the faint of heart, and Raquelle has talked me through every single argument, squabble, or moment of self-doubt I've had in my career while also helping me continue to shine my light. I hope the Sunshine Mind is a lifesaver for you. I hope it brings you steadiness. I pray it restores hope in your heart in the places where you may have lost it. I pray that this book and the Sunshine Mindset creates a beautiful community of people who want to live life through hope-colored glasses. Enjoy, Tanya.
Introducing Raquelle. I remember meeting Tanya Rad at her first night of Bible study like it was yesterday. Even though I had grown up in church, the Bible study Jason Kennedy had started was a special place for me. I had recently moved to LA from Chicago, and I was lonely. Shortly after moving, I had prayed, God, if LA is where I'm meant to be, I pray that I would make the best friends I've ever made in my life and that you would make it clear to me or I'm moving back to Chicago. I gave myself a one-year timeline, and a few months after I said that prayer, I walked into Bible study and met Tanya. I instantly knew she was one of those friends I had prayed for. After we met, we made plans for lunch. And it was then that she opened up about the challenges she was having at work. People saying she was too positive, too nice, and that she would never make it in this industry because people never get to the top being that way. My advice to her was to keep being herself, because that's exactly why God had given her that position, to spread her light and positivity, to be different in an industry that can sometimes be toxic. Through our friendship and our shared spirituality, no matter how hard life got, Tanya always stayed true to who she is, and that is something I admire and respect. Now, after almost 9 years of friendship, I have seen her year after year continually choose the high road, and I am so proud of the woman she has become. The light she gives out on television, the radio, her podcast, and social media is truly remarkable. I believe God has honored her efforts to stay true to herself because that's exactly who He created her to be, and I'm so grateful to be her friend. When Tanya approached me about writing this book together, I thought of how beautiful it is that our faith journeys have led us both here. As we were coming up with the title for this book, something that resonated with both of us was the word sunshine. With both of us being eternal optimists, people often assume life is easy for us, that we wake up happy every morning. But that couldn't be further from the truth. Like everyone else, we face challenges and hard times, which affect us deeply. I truly love God, love life, and love people. My greatest desire has always been, and will always be, to spread God's love to people, and in return, to see people live free. Most of all, I want to help you shine to your fullest potential. I am truly honored that you've picked up the Sunshine Mind, and it's my hope and prayer that you will find freedom, love, and light in the best thing I have ever known and will ever know, a relationship with God. Raquelle.
Acknowledgements. We have so many people to thank for helping bring this devotional to life. It was a giant combination of people being generous with their connections, resources, and time. We could not have done this without every single one of you. First, we'd like to thank Erica Munger, Scrub Sisters for Life, for connecting us to our publisher, Zondervan. You are the spark that got this fire going. To our entire team at Zondervan, Carolyn McCready, our fearless leader, Alicia Kaysen, Paul Fisher, Sarah Falter, Matt Bray, Devin Duke, Kim Tanner, Brenda Snodderly, and Bridget Brooks. We could not have done this without you. Thank you for seeing our heart, passion, and vision for this project. To Allie Kingsley Baker, our right hand on this project, you are the Sunshine Mind in human form. Working with you on this was truly a blessing. We would have been lost without you. Thank you for believing in us. Thank you for not only your time, effort, and energy, but also your leadership and knowledge in this literary world we were navigating for the first time, and hopefully on future ones to come. To Robbie, our agent on this deal, and Tanya's better half, thank you for your time and energy and being our legal eyes on the details. Robbie, you have been my greatest gift. I am so lucky to do life with you by my side. I love you so much. Tanya. To our parents, Sam, Bronco, Dushanka, and Heidi, we are forever grateful for your unwavering and unconditional love and support. To every single person that listens to the morning show or scrubbing in or follows us on social media, thank you for being a part of this journey with us. Your constant encouragement has lit us up from the inside out. This book is for all of you.
Introduction. We're so glad you're here with us to learn about and share in our mindset, the Sunshine Mind. We see this mindset as a daily practice. It's not a formula or a quick fix, but rather the way you go about your life each day, one day at a time. We all know life can throw us a mean curveball. Facing challenges is part of the human experience. As you listen through this devotional, we hope your faith is strengthened each day and you are able to navigate life's obstacles with positivity, grace, and light. Because living life with a sunshine mindset means exuding light, positivity, and promise. The Sunshine Mind will restore your hope, give you practical ways to deal with the stresses that come with this digital age, and help you shine from the inside out. We knew this book was necessary because we listened to you. Whether it was those of you who messaged us on social media or walked right up to us while we were out and about, asking for better ways to conquer anxiety, overcome stress, or become stronger than the pressures of trying to live up to the world's expectations. We read and took.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.